Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for December 2nd, 2022. Well, yesterday we had a considerable round of economic data that wasn't all that bullish, yet the market just refuses to stop this bullish move to the upside. The bears just don't have any energy at all. And even though that economic data continues to show us that our economy is slowing, and particularly that our manufacturing is in contraction, we just want to be a buyer in this market. So we continue to push up after a little bit of pullback yesterday in the indexes. The bulls came right back in and began to push back up. And you can see this morning, although we have some bearish activity in Asia last night and Europe this morning, we've got nothing but a pre-market pump going on, pushing the markets higher here in the morning in anticipation of some more economic data. So what does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in, let's buckle up, let's get ready for the Friday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. Well, good morning and happy Friday, everyone. Let's take a look at these charts and see if we can get some information about how we may want to approach the market for today. First off, the thing you have to just really give up here to the bulls is they are holding in here very strong, breaking through this resistance. Now, this is a very parabolic move, and it would be pretty extraordinary to see that steep of a trend be maintained much longer than we have already maintained it. It's kind of a remarkable upside trend here, considering we're still going to be raising rates and our economy is slowing. But watching that closely, there's nothing in this chart right now that suggests that the bulls are willing to give up and that the bears are starting to take over. So you have to stay bearish and stay with this trend right now, because the bulls continue to hold on, and this is a very, very bullish chart. Now, if we see some bullish inspiration today in those economic numbers that come out, then let's look for a retest of this resistance high here in the market, and that would test some significant levels of price resistance over here in the chart. If the bears find some inspiration, well, we've already tested this level in here. We may actually see that level be tested if those bears find inspiration. I can't say that they will. There's nothing in this chart that would suggest that. And we have seen a lot of Fridays here recently where if there's not a lot of economic data, it's just plow into the market, just buy, buy, buy. So we could get another repeat of that today and extend us right on up here in that chart. Now let's take a look at our SPY. Our SPY, very similar situation, but much stronger than the Dow was. As you can see, we pulled back, but there was very little selling that was inspired by those economic data points yesterday. So if we get some bullish inspiration today, it really wouldn't be that big of an effort here to see us push right back up and test that resistance high here in the SPY, and maybe even push on through. And if we do push through, I would suggest we move up into that area right there on the SPY. Now, keeping in mind, we have a little bit of an additional challenge here in the SPY to overcome, and that is that downtrend line in the chart. So we have a little bit of a double whammy in here, where we've got that pretty substantial resistance in price action here and that downtrend that we're going to have to defeat this morning on any bullish inspiration. Now, keep in mind, if those bears are inspired, well, I would suggest maybe a pullback into here would be possible. And if that were to fail, then again, kind of a full whipsaw of that big pop day that we experienced on Wednesday. So watch that close. Now let's take a look at our QQQ. QQQ continues to be one of the weaker indexes in the market, but boy, Wednesday sure changed a lot here in the appearance of that chart. This is very, very bullish, holding that price support, holding on to that trend. Yet at the same time, we have this complication in here that we haven't been able to break that downtrend yet. And of course, we have a fairly significant level of price resistance across here that we've yet to deal with. So once again here in the QQQ, we have a bit of that double whammy of extra resistance in the chart to try and break through. That being said, if the bulls can find inspiration, you can see yesterday there was virtually no pullback in that economic data yesterday on the NASDAQ. They just wanted to continue to plow into tech stocks yesterday. So holding up in here, I would suggest maybe on a bullish inspiration, we would retest that high that we saw yesterday before we pulled back a little bit. And if we can push on through that, then I'm going to suggest maybe we come up into here on that bullish activity, just looking at the chart. Now, if we find bearish inspiration, then once again, I'm going to point out that we really could pull back into here to retest that support level. And if they are unable to hold that, that would really create a pretty ugly situation, a nasty little whipsaw in the market. So watch carefully. I don't see any inspiration for that right now, however, to just really tuck tail and run. And I'm not seeing the bears gain any strength to attack just yet. So I'm not particularly worried about that, and particularly on a Friday. Let's take a look at our Russell. The IWM chart had a little bit of bearish pressure in there yesterday in that price action, but nothing major. And as you can see, IWM has been able to sneak out from underneath that downtrend right here. It all depends on how you draw that chart. If you pick up some of the wicks in here in the chart, we're just right up there testing it. So keep a close eye on that, but we're trying once again to push this through in that upside move. And if we look right in here, we do have a fairly significant price resistance in that chart. So if the bulls find inspiration here today, look for that retest of yesterday's high in here. And if we can push through that, then maybe just a little bit higher into some price action resistance in the chart. And if those bears fight back and they start coming in, maybe a retest of support down in here. We kind of tested that yesterday, kind of a light test. Actually, if I push this up right there to the wick, a complete test of that level right there. But a little bit more downside might occur if we get some bearish inspiration. And then once again, there's not much other price action help in here on support. If that level breaks, we could come down into this level. Now, I wouldn't be majorly concerned about that, because if we look at this on the IWM, if we push back into this level, that's just the trend in the chart. So nothing particular to worry about there. If we were to take a look at our VIX, I gotta tell you, is really beginning to concern me here a little bit, because what we have seen in this massive push to the upside is quite a little bit of complacency. We're really ignoring the economic numbers out there. Just absolutely unconcerned that our economy is slowing down. And as we know that the Fed is going to be coming up here in a couple of weeks with another rate increase of probably 50 basis points, I just don't think that's a good situation in the market to be ignoring. But that being said, the bulls are definitely in control here, and there is no sign in the VIX that they're willing to give up just yet. We have another level of support being tested here in that chart, and if we break on down through there, well, pretty remarkable with the conditions that we see in our economic numbers that we are maintaining this much bullishness. And I think what we're starting to see is a bit of complacency in the VIX. So watch that close. And then if we take a look at our T2122 is once again very elevated up here. We held on yesterday, even though we pulled back a bit in the Dow particularly. We held up in here in a very strong pattern. But we are elevated. If the bulls can find inspiration, I want you to notice that there really isn't a whole lot of room in here for them to continue to push. If the bears find inspiration, well, obviously we have a pretty big downside opportunity if they find reason to attack. So keep a close eye on that. We might be getting a little bit long in the tooth on this this rally into the downtrends of those indexes. And at any point in time, we could start to see that resting pullback. So I would really want to suggest it might be wise to be watching carefully for those bear attacks. You might be thinking about taking some profits in your trades if those bear attacks start to show up. And just remember, as we slide into this weekend, anything is possible next week after such an extended move to the upside here in the market. Let's take a look at our T2108. Here again, we've got to give this up to the bulls. The bulls are holding in there tremendously strong. And I want you to notice that over the years here, this is multiple years back, you look across here, when we reach up into these areas here, we are getting into some pretty rarefied air. And if we find that bullish inspiration today and we push up into these areas, that's something to be paying attention to, that it's pretty rare for us to see that much bullishness all at once in the market. 73% of the stocks above their 40-day moving average, pretty remarkable. So just kind of keep that in mind. We're a little bit stretched out here. Our T2107 showing us the same thing. We pushed right by this August high in here, pressing up, and we're continuing to press this higher. Almost 50% of the stocks now back above their 200-day moving average. Very remarkable extension, but one thing you want to make note of is we're pushing our way into a pretty substantial resistance zone here in that chart. So once again, we may be reaching some of that little bit of rarefied air here at the moment with that overextension. Watch that closely for those potential. I'm not saying it's going to happen, but that potential, the bears could attack at any time. And if they don't see a pretty substantial pullback, we could go into a longer term consolidation just to kind of consolidate this big move. So another reason to be watching carefully for some profits. If we take a look at our T2101 just continues to act pretty confused, and there's some understandability why that would be just a little bit confused. If we look at our volume yesterday, volume improved a bit on the SPY, but was pretty darn low. QQQ was also lower than average, and IWM was lower than average. The only one that had substantial volume yesterday was the diamonds, and that's because of the big point move that we created in the Dow from a very parabolic position in the Dow. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. And our economic calendar doesn't have a whole lot on it to be to provide us a lot of guidance on the day. We're going to hit this first. We got motor vehicle sales numbers out, and then we're going to get this employment situation number this morning. Remember, in the employment numbers right now, in the jobs numbers, good news is bad news. So if the jobs numbers come in strong, that would be bad for the market. If those job numbers come in weak, then that may be bullish for the market right now, because that would say that the FOMC should start backing off on rate increases. So watch that carefully. Now, if we take a look past that, we've just got a bunch of Fed talk here in the market and not much else. The Baker Hughes rig count unlikely to move us around much. So not much else to be inspired by on the day. And unfortunately, when we look at the earnings calendar, there's not a whole lot to be inspired there by either. I've only got two stocks that I put on the list for notables today. CBRL reporting, trying to push up a little bit here this morning. You might want to keep an eye on that one. And GCO. There just really isn't a whole lot to provide inspiration on that economic calendar or earnings calendar, and that's going to continue to diminish as we head into the end of this year. So watch that carefully. Now let's take a look at some stocks that could be setting up for today. But before we do that, guys, if you could do me that quick favor, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that subscribe button on YouTube and then also click that bell icon when it pops up so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you find these videos to be useful or helpful, if you could please do me that favor also in clicking that thumbs up button and leaving a brief comment, helps the channel to continue to grow. And I just want to say thanks so much to everyone who does do that. I know it's a monotonous every single day, but it is very much appreciated because there's a lot of effort that goes into putting these videos together every day. And I just want to say thank you so much to everyone who does take the time. Let's take a look at some of these stocks that could be setting up for today. And remember, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any security. As a matter of fact, you're really going to have to do your own due diligence. We are quite stretched out here in the short term of the market. So I would suggest, probably not a whole lot of rushing into buy positions right now. Maybe wait for a little rest or pullback in the market to occur. But that being said, there are a lot of signals out there to be watching for and a lot of stocks that have moved up very sharply in the market. First off, one of the things that's helping us in the market is seeing this dramatic pullback that we have experienced here in the dollar. But one thing I want you to notice this morning is we tried to pop the dollar pretty hard here again. A little bit of volatility in this dollar this morning. So if the dollar remains weak, that's going to help our market stay bullish here, I think, for a little bit because we've needed that to pull back. However, if we start to see that dollar strengthen a little bit, you'll want to watch that pretty closely. And after such a steep sell-off here, a bounce could occur at any time. So kind of keep an eye on that US dollar. Now, having talked about that, as you guys know, I have been mentioning gold and silver to be keeping an eye on gold, silver, steel, copper, all of those kind of stocks. And I've been repeating that all week. And oh my goodness, yesterday did we go like a rocket shot. Gold futures increased by over $57 an ounce yesterday, a big spike in gold. So keep an eye on this. I wouldn't chase this at this point. As a matter of fact, I would expect some kind of rest or pullback to occur in gold. But if you've not positioned yourself in a little bit of the precious metals, it might be a time to start watching carefully for that next opportunity in the trade. A little rest or pullback in here could set up that opportunity. And with the uncertainty that we're starting to see that we've seen all year in crypto blockchain type names, gold seems to be picking up a little bit of inspiration here in the market. So watch that closely. And in anytime the US dollar declines in value, gold normally responds bullishly. If we also take a look at silver, we've got the same thing going on here in silver. Just a rocket shot to the upside yesterday in silver. I would suggest you might want to keep an eye on this. A little rest or pullback could set up that opportunity to pick up some precious metals here. Now, on the other hand, not so precious metals, we have pretty good moves going on in steel. And usually when we see dollar fall, all commodity prices strengthen to the upside. And we've seen a pretty substantial move here in these steel stocks, and they're holding up very, very well. So keep an eye on stocks like U.S. Steel, Steel Dynamics, MT, all of these steel producing stocks are doing pretty darn well and holding up very strong. Other places you may want to look in the market, take a look at utilities. We've had a nice upside run here in utilities and holding in here very, very strong overall. We're breaking through these resistance levels, holding these levels as support. Any consolidating move in here could set up that next opportunity to the upside and maybe attack these next resistance levels in the chart. So keep an eye on those utilities. And you know, one of the cool things about TC2000, that's the software I use here, I can just click one icon and I can bring up a list of utilities, and I can jump right to these stocks that are showing so much bullishness in the market to make some decisions on whether I want to pick up some of those trades. So watch that close. Utilities seem to be staying quite strong. Another place that has been showing lots of improvement here is in the consumer discretionary sector. Take a look at how we moved up so sharply here on Wednesday in consumer discretionary. Now we're running into some price resistance in this chart, but keep a close eye on this. When the market starts to get extended like this, and we start to see, or we keep hearing about the reports that next year could be pretty tough with recession and those kind of things, what we could begin to see is a little bit of a shift where we could see folks moving over to more of the discretionary items, more of the defensive sector items in the market, because they pay a nice dividend yield. So keep an eye on this. This wouldn't be ready for prime time just yet, but if this were to pop through here and hold that higher low, it might be something to be paying attention to. And once again, you could jump right into some of these names with a single click and start looking at some of those names that may be providing some nice dividend yield, nice safety type stocks for that upside move. And speaking of safety type stocks, let's take a look at some old boring defensive companies out there like Coca-Cola. You can see we're getting these nice upside moves. We're moving back up here to test some resistance highs. Again, I think there might be just a little bit of a tiny shift starting to show itself that we're picking up in some of these old boring defensive sector companies. So keep an eye on that. These are dividend yielding companies. As we break out of these downtrends, hold higher lows, there may be some opportunities. Now I will tell you that I would expect a longer term rest or consolidation to occur in that chart. And the reason I say that is when I draw this upside trend, it's pretty unlikely that we can maintain such a steep trend for too terrible long here in some of these stocks. So a resting pattern in here might be the next move in that market, but that means we have plenty of time to plan to pick up some of these potential trades. Take a look at KHC. KHC is another one that I mentioned just the other day, and I placed a price alert on this chart. And as you can see, popping through that downtrend, again, another boring, just an old food company out there, but old boring might be a pretty good place looking at the data coming in right now. We could have a tough year next year, and we might be looking for some of those simple old boring companies to provide some safety and some good returns heading into next year. So watch that close. We may be seeing a little tiny rotation starting to occur into some of those defensive names. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great results in your trading. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks so much for supporting the channel. I truly, truly appreciate it. And I want to wish you all a fantastic weekend with you and your family. Be safe, be careful, and I'll see you right back here, bright and early Monday morning. Wish you all the best.